Hi, welcome to this week's vlog. We're in the Bosworth room right now, and then we're going to head out into retail in a little bit. First, let's look at some new arrivals for the Bosworth collection. Right here, we have the Snauert Graphite Composite. These rackets were prepared to the spec of Sandy Mayer, a professional player back in the day. This has got a wood core, so it's got an ash, all white ash core to it, and then overlaid on that, you have braided graphite. So it's wood ash sandwiched between braided graphite. Modern racket design, kind of using a mixture of contemporary and modern racket manufacturing materials right there. So right at the end of the wood era. Another open throat wood racket here, also using graphite in the construction. So you've got a laminated wood and graphite. And this is the Snauert Graphite Composite Legrand racket. A really popular racket back in the day. A beautiful cosmetic on this one. Great collectible and a lot of fun to hit with. Comes with the first quality Snauert lever grip. Really nice stick. Moving into graphite rackets now, we have Fischer Pro Classic 98. This is a brand new old stock racket. So right around 98, this racket was in production, and this one's still got the plastic on the handle, brand new, and they're all like that. Great collectible, and also if you're a fan of those, some of the older Fischer rackets, great one to take out and hit with. Another racket from the same era is the VT Vacuum Technic Pro 98. This one was used on the Pro Tour, as was the blue one by Medvedev, and I think Yevgeny Kafelnikov from Russia was also swinging this stick. Really nice player's stick and quality racket from Fischer. Fun to hit with, also a great collectible. Here we have the Yonex RQ260. This is a player's racket weight, but it's a wide body. See how thick the beam is right here, as you come out of the throat into the lower section of the hoop, and then it tapers up towards the tip back to a thinner profile. So it's a, you know, it's a nice sort of probably be right around sort of 12.2 ounces strong, the weight on this racket, but it's got a little bit of wide body power to it too. Got some older Gamma rackets as well coming into stock. This is the Tradition 18, and this is a thin-beamed player's racket. It was a popular racket back in the day. I remember a couple of teaching pro buddies of mine were using this when Gamma were producing these rackets. Really nice racket and had a strong following. Again, it's collectible because you know these are not made anymore. They're in brand new condition. Also a lot of fun to hit with if you're looking for a nice solid player's graphite racket. Right here we have the Tradition 20. This one's got a slightly wider beam. It's also got the crossbar stabilizer right there. It's a mid-plus player's racket again, a little bit more maneuverable than the 18. Really nice graphite racket, also in brand new condition. One thing you should be wary of, you know, with the older rackets, when you remove the plastic from the handle, some of the grip come off. So you might need to put a new grip on if you want to use one of these as a hitter. Also up here, we have the Super RQ 700 long. These rackets were prepared to the spec of Monica Seles. So they might have a little bit of weight, and that might vary from frame to frame. And then also there's some slight use on these rackets. So they have been used, and this grip came with a naturally distressed look, but also you can see this one's got some use on it. It's wrapped nice and high for a two-handed player. And a really nice collectible, and also a great hitter. That's it for the Bosworth collection. Let's head back out into retail, and we'll look at some new products just arrived at the warehouse. Okay, so we're up above retail right now. We just looked at some older Gamma rackets in the Bosworth collection. Let's look at some of the newer ones. Just came in. This is the Gamma G250. So it's 250 gram racket. It's going to put it slightly over 8 ounces. That's unstrung weight. This one's an oversized racket, so you get 110 square inches. The main strings are really long, so you get, you know, a lot of travel with the main strings when you hit the balls. So you get a lot of pop, a lot of ball speed off the racket face. Nice open string pattern, so it's got plenty of bite for when you want to add a little bit of spin. Really nice big sweet spot on this racket. Plenty of pop, very comfortable, and a good racket for sort of like someone around the 3.5 to 4.0 level looking for, you know, nice maneuverable stick that offers some power. Moving slightly up in weight and down in head size to a 105, so you're right on the cusp of mid-size, mid-plus and an oversized racket. This is the G260, slightly heavier, slightly smaller head, so a bit more control. Great stick, I think, for a baseline player. He's looking, generate some ball speed, get some nice spin, but lots of control and feel. Got a nice kind of tribal design right here at the 3 and 9 position there on the hoop, and that's a really nice playing stick as well. This is the Gamma G325. This is the heaviest player's racket, 11.5 ounces unstrung. It's got a really nice thin beam, really nice flex from the throat of this racket when you play. I've hit with this racket quite a bit. It's a nice playing stick. A lot of feel, a lot of control. It's flexible, so the ball stays on the racket. You can generate spin, and a really nice player's racket. If you're looking for a player's racket, well worth a demo on that one. This is the G310, a little bit wider beam than the one we just looked at, the 325. This one, it's got a bit more pop. Again, nice open string pan, so you're getting plenty of bite from the string bed. Good mixture of power, control, and spin, really. Really nice racket right there. And then the return of the Big Bubba. This is the Big Bubba 28. 28 inches long, gigantic, 137 square inch head size. This is a great racket for a complete beginner who wants to maximize their fun on the tennis court, as well as a senior player who's maybe lost a step or two and is looking for some extra reach and a lot of extra power. So it's got kind of a wide beam and a massive head. Sweet spots don't get any bigger than this. So that's the Big Bubba 28. Okay, so here we are back in the warehouse. Let's take a look at some new string that just arrived. Thank you. This is a new string band called Weiss Cannons from Germany, and they make great polyester strings. We've got sets and reels. This one is the Scorpion. This one's a copolymer monomix, so it's reinforced high-grade copolyester. Really firm string bed, lots of control, lots of access to spin, great durability from a string like this. And this one's fairly soft for a poly, so you get a little bit of ball pocketing. It's really going to spit the ball off those strings with some nice topspin or slice. Thank you. Here we have Weiss Cannon Silver String. This one's also a high-grade copolymer. It's got a fluorocarbon integrated with the string material, so it's extruded. When they make polyester string, they kind of squirt it out of a tube. Kind of imagine if toothpaste coming out of a tube. So it's extruded out, and it's a monofilament, so you just got one long filament. So both materials integrated into the filament. This one's silver string and also got sets and reels in that. Thank you. And then this one's match power, the orange, sets and reels as well. And this one's got the nanotechnology in it. It's a really soft copolymer string, so you get even more ball pocket than the other two strings. Some good spin, a bit more pace, a bit more pop for a poly, even though polys are very much control-oriented strings. This one is going to give you a little bit more ball speed off the racket face. Nice string and good comfort on that one. Okay, let's take a look at a new bag from Head. This is the Head Extreme bag. This one's the 9-pack. Also comes in a 6-pack. What we have here is on the accessory pocket, got a spot where you can put your MP3 player and your cell phone, and a little port right there for the cable to come out. So inside this pocket, boom, there's your MP3 player, there's your cell phone, put your keys on there, you stay nice and organized. And this in the main compartment. So there's your carry strap. Here's the main compartment. This is where you throw all your extra Microgel Extreme rackets right there. You've got a shoe or wet dry pocket on the end, and it's vented, so when you throw your wet gear in or your shoes, they can breathe. They don't get too scary when you go to take them out. Another vented pocket at this end with a smaller accessory pocket. And then on the side of the bag right here, we have climate control technology, so you can throw a couple of rackets in here. It's nice and thick, so they're not going to get dinged up even if you're traveling and you check this bag. And this silver lining here will protect the bags from excessive heat. So if you're out on the court and it's really hot, or you've got the bags in the car, they're not going to get really cooked, which is really bad for the graphite frame. It'll hold 2 or 3 Microgel Extremes, no problem. Then you've got another large accessory pocket right there where you can throw extra sets of string, extra grips, sunblock, you know, spare hat, what have you, when you need it. That's all we've got for this week. Make sure you join us next week, and we'll update you with our next vlog on new products arriving at the warehouse.